Hey friends, it's Brian, and it's time for another episode of my junky truck restoration build project. So I've got a 1990 F-350 with an IDI 7.3 diesel in it. And what we're doing today is building a new glowplug harness. So I've got some 14-gauge GXL rated wire right here. And I've run cables from the glowplug controller, which is relocated over there, to a terminal block. And so now I've got to go from terminal block to the glow plugs. So first thing I need to do is figure out what's the length all the way to the back. So that's what we're gonna do right now. And I'm gonna make the wires the same length. There's a reason for this. It'll keep them all getting the same voltage by making the resistance the same to each glow plug. So 14 gauge wire is good for 20 amps. That should be it right there. Okay, so now let's see what this is going to look like over here. I'm gonna go run some calculations. I'll be right back. So, we're gonna call this 2 feet of wire to 1 foot of wire takes it from 0.005 ohms to 0.027. So it basically doubles the resistance when you shorten the wire or lengthen the wire. So make all the wires the same length. And that'll create some routing issues, but whatever. Let's go do it. All right, so first things first, let's make 8 wires. Cutters went. Oh, whatever. Great, we have just a little bit left over. That's exactly how we want it. So there's our, throw that on the ground. The cusser will be on the ground later. And here's the old one. So, you know, this is what's wrong with it. It's got bare wires and it's... So, let's put my trash can over. Thank you. need bullet connectors. Ring. Ring. Bullet. So these are now need to be heat shrunk, so let me go find the heat shrink gun and we'll get all these heat shrunk. All right, so that's this step. Next, we need to put a fusible link on the other end. So let's collect them, make sure we still got all eight. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, we still have 8, so let's put fusible links on the end. Now I need butt connectors. Let me go find them. Okay, so got my connectors, and we're gonna get busy putting the first part on. So these, the way they sell this particular brand of connector is a little irritating. You have to buy like just large quantities of them. However, it's worth it because everything just works, and it makes solid connections every time, the first time, and their connectors are calibrated to their crimpers, and everything just works. So, all right, on to our next. So we've got fusible links that we bought. Got a pretty good deal on these. We're just gonna extract the wire that we need. prefer them all to be the same color, but it doesn't really matter at the end of the day. My hand is going to sleep on me. I got some kind of problem going on with my left arm. All right, so. To figure out what size heat shrink goes over these. Well, first we need to heat shrink those individually, so let me get started on that. You guys have already seen heat shrink gun, so I'm not going to video this again. Alright, so we're putting the ring terminals on that will go to the terminal lugs that I installed adjacent to the fuel filter. If you want to know more about that, there's a separate video. It's a little short, but it'll probably work. You just got to get underneath the crimp lug. There we go. All right. Now it's time to heat shrink all those, and all the wires will be built. So there you have it. We have 8 new glow plug wires that all have a fusible link built in. I was going to originally put something over this, but actually, this is heat shrink. It's sealed. I don't need to do anything else with it. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And I've chosen to keep them all the same length. I'll deal with that when it comes to the routing when I install these. I'm not going to install them tonight. So that's going to be it for the video. I've got 4 leftovers. Oops. Whatever. I got a really good deal on these. They were clearance at Rock Auto, so they were like $1.50 a piece. And I think I bought the last of them, by the way. This is the crap that came with the terminal lug. It's going to recycle. Let me look outside and see if this is going to get installed today. So I wasn't going to put these in, but honestly, this is the nicest part of the weather in the summer, is this last hour and a half or 2 hours before the sun sets. So yeah, I'm going to take advantage of it. Now, your mileage may vary, and what I'm doing is completely of my own design. I'm gonna get a wrench for that. I'll be right back. Oh, wrong size. Right back. hoses gives me something to lean on. Oh, that's frustrating. This could have been shorter. Make them shorter. Is it worth 6 inches? Length's okay. Alright, so that's there. This is here. That's there. And this one is here. super pretty, but it'll be okay. Yeah, that's gonna be fine. All right. So we got these installed. Everything's wired down. I don't think the clips are going to fit back on top of the brackets. So let's see. We can do is get these on here to stop accidental contact. All right, so let's see if I can get the batteries back in and see if it'll start. Let's see if it works. Let's see if it starts. Sorry for the light to get back. So rosy. Acting like I've got two dead batteries. Make sure I have it hooked up right. Positive. Connected. Positive. Thank you. and see if I get power in the truck. Voltage of the truck now. All right, so we got voltage there. It might actually run. Let's find out. Thank you. right, folks, thanks for watching. That's it for tonight. We've got the truck back to running and my fast idle solenoid sticking, but hey, whatever. I mean, if that's the least of my problems, it seems like the glow plugs work. The controller isn't clicking. And I've got all new wires here and they work. I think that's a very successful end to this project for tonight.